We want to find the equation of the vertical asymptote to each log function. Our first function is f of x equals log of the quantity x minus 4. Notice how there's no base given, so we know this is base 10 or common log. So we could rewrite this as y equals log base 10 of the quantity x minus 4. We should know by now that this is equivalent to the exponential equation 10 raised to the power of y is equal to the quantity x minus 4. So we know x can be any value that would be equal to 10 raised to the power of y, but 10 raised to the power of y is always going to be positive. That's the reason why to find the domain, we solve the inequality x minus 4 is greater than 0. And then to find the equation of the vertical asymptote, we need to solve the equation x minus 4 equals 0. So if we solve this inequality for x, we would add 4 to both sides. The domain is x is greater than 4. And then if we solve this equation for 4, we'd have x equals 4, which would be the equation of the vertical asymptote. So notice that the x value can get closer and closer to positive 4. It just can't equal positive 4, because if it did, we'd have 10 to the power of y equals 0, which cannot occur. Now we'll take a look at this graphically as well in just a moment. But let's take a look at our second exponential function. We have f of x equals natural log of the quantity x plus 1. Remember, natural log is log base e. So we could write this as y equals log base e of the quantity x plus 1. And then in exponential form, we'd have e raised to the power of y equals the quantity x plus 1. So in this form, it's easier to see the domain would have to occur when x plus 1 is greater than 0. And therefore, the equation of the vertical asymptote would occur where x plus 1 equals 0. Again, for the domain, we solve the inequality x plus 1 is greater than 0. And then for the vertical asymptote, we solve the equation x plus 1 equals 0. So we'll subtract 1 on both sides. We have x is greater than negative 1 for the domain. And then we subtract 1 on both sides of the equation. We have x equals negative 1 for the equation of the vertical asymptote. Let's verify this graphically as well. Again, our first log function was common log, or log base 10. So in exponential form, we would have 10 to the power of y equals quantity x minus 4. To graph this by hand, we'd select values of y and then solve for x, which would produce this blue graph here. Notice how the graph approaches positive 4 but never reaches it, and that's why we have a vertical asymptote at x equals positive 4. Just keep in mind the graph never does touch this vertical line, x equals 4. And that's the reason why our domain is x is greater than positive 4. And then for our second log function, the natural log function, in exponential form, we would have e raised to the power of y equals the quantity x plus 1. We take a look at the graph of this function. Here's our vertical asymptote at x equals negative 1. The graph approaches this line but never touches it. And our domain is x is greater than negative 1. Okay, I hope the explanations as well as the graphs help you better understand the domain as well as the equation of the vertical asymptotes.